An interesting dynamic, don't you think, setting up here as Canada's Jeffrey Buttle, the silver medalist from the last World Championships, faces his predecessor of sorts, the silver medalist from 2004 at the Worlds, France's own Brian Joubert.
And Jeff Buttle has a bit of a battle of his own here because he's coming off a very disappointing skate at Skate Canada where he pretty much self-destructed. He's got two fabulous new programs. We have yet to see them skated to their potential. Hopefully, it's going to be here.
But Buttle is in a similar situation to that of France's Brian Joubert in that both of these men came onto the Grand Prix circuit this year and delivered subpar preliminary performances. Joubert was at Skate America. He did not skate very well. He comes into this competition, has the pressure of trying to unload that baggage, and in doing so, in front of his hometown audience. After his performance at Skate America, there was a lot of pressure on him, not only for not skating well, but delivering a program that many feel may not be Olympic in its magnitude.
Well, doesn't that play in beautifully to what Barb said at the top of our broadcast, which is many of these figure skaters are going to tweak their programs, and some are going to be so bitterly disappointed, they're going to dump them all together and get something new for the Olympics. It's all very interesting as we look at the results for the men after their short program. Great news for Canada's Jeffrey Buttle. He's in the lead after the short. 2004 World Silver medalist Brian Joubert of France is currently in second. And there's Jorge Keeper of Romania, a bit of a surprise third. Here are comments from Jeff Buttle after his short.
At Skate Canada, I was a little bit nervous. It was my first time competing internationally. Today, you know, it just felt so natural. I felt like I was in a show, you know, just I got into that groove where I could enjoy the program but do the stuff at the same time.
Now, in terms of the quad, do you think you're going to have to include it for the Olympics? Are you happy with where you are now with just leaving it in the free program?
That's a good question. I think I'm happy with where the quad is right now. It's improving quite a bit throughout the year. It's a lot better than it was last year at this time, landing a couple on practice every day. So I think we're going to include it in the program for the long program tomorrow. And then, you know, we're just going to see how it progresses throughout the year before we decide on the Olympics.
Well, in fact, tomorrow is today, and it is the free skate. And here is the first skater of the final group, Canada's Jeffrey Buttle. Again, he is the world champion, silver medalist, and is first after the short program. His rendition and tribute, if you will, to the pianist from Canada, the great Glenn Gould.
Speaking of the quad, it will be his first jump here today, and he has not completed it successfully since 2003. And he gets the full rotation. He could just not hang on to that landing, though.
That miss, quick question, how is that reflected in the scoring?
Anytime you fall in the program anywhere, it's a minus one. If you fall in a jump, it's a minus three. So we add the two together, he loses 4 points.
Triple axel combination here. And again, he flips off that landing edge.
After struggling with the first two jump elements of this program, he comes back with a solid triple lutz, double toe, double loop combination. Thank you.
second triple axel planned here, which he needs. And he pops that wide open into a single. And that's leaving major points on the table.
I would think with the three errors on eight of the allowable jump windows, technically this program is not going to be amongst the leading scoring efforts of the day. If it is, this is not going to be a well-skated competition. Even that triple lutz looked a bit hesitant. I mean, yes, it was well done, but you could just tell from his body language that he's not completely comfortable out there.
Barb and Paul, I'm wondering, in the aftermath of Olympic programs, which includes soundtracks, I'm thinking of Elvis Stoiko movie soundtracks, big orchestra and orchestrated pieces, and I'm thinking Plushenko. Does this work for an Olympics?
I think with a decent effort in terms of getting all of the material that's in the program done, yes. It's got a subtlety about it that I quite enjoy. It's been well received by the panel, given the marks he received at his last competition for this very same program, so I don't think there's any problem with the vehicle. It's those mistakes that are currently his hang-up.
Closing combination spin here. All his spins are of very high difficulty. He'll score high on the spins. But the jumps just weren't here today.
No, Barb, they certainly weren't, as Canada's Jeffrey Buttle did battle the tough technical components of that free skate.
Well, the thing that might concern me for Jeff is the fact that there's been two competitions in a row where he has had difficulty with the big ticket jumps within the context of the program, and he's really going to have to get over this hurdle to stay ranked as a contender. Here's the quad. You're going to see on the replay, the landing is what they're looking at, and I don't think for a moment that was a fully rotated quad jump. He's likely only received credit for doing a triple there. And here's the triple axel. Not strong enough on the breakout. He's still fully pulled in when he makes contact with the ice. But this was the triple lutz combination, which did go well for him. Takes the time to reload. Triple lutz, double toe, double loop.
All of Jeff's spins will score high on difficulty.
Keep in mind, Jeffrey Buttle had the lead after the short program with a score of 76.08, which just was a mere point and a third off his personal best, along with coach Lee Barkel. It'll be very interesting to see where these technical element scores come, because you mentioned the under-rotation of the quad. That would be reflected in the technical element scores.
The technical element score.
And the monitors come up, and the controller has given him credit for a quad. I can't believe that they would do that, given the under-rotation that we saw in the instant replay of that jump.
However, Buttle is rewarded mightily for the program components, and so gives him a first-place finish thus far for the free skate and the lead in the overall competition with a total of 215.48. So Canada's Jeffrey Buttle has the lead at the Grand Prix of France.
I did a nice quad on the warm-up. It was a little bit tight in the program, so I mean that's something I can take away from here and make sure that I do better for the next competition. Other than that, I had some trouble with the axel on the warm-up, and I think going out there I just wanted to try harder, so they ended up getting too big. The first one I over-rotated, and the second one just got so big with the free leg that I turned it into a single.
Well, this next skater didn't have trouble with the quads back in 2002. When he won the bronze medal and became the first man to land three quads in the Olympic program. Here is, from the United States, Timothy Gabel. The 25-year-old is fourth after the short program.
And fortunately for Timmy, he's the type of skater who built his foundation around his jumps. It was all about the jump under the old 6.0 system, and Timmy fully capitalized on that. The new system doesn't work that way, and he's struggled trying to make the adjustment to round out all aspects of his skating.
And he is openly against the new scoring system, saying that it holds back skaters from setting new standards in the sport, quote unquote.
He has been struggling with the quads recently. He's setting up for his first one here, and he pulls out midair, barely rotates a double. Back and get his focus for this triple axel. And no, he pops that one as well.
Solid triple loop jump.
Tim Gable, in his second Grand Prix event, in the opener of the season, he finished, in his words, a disappointing sixth at Skate America.
Setting up for his second attempt at the triple axel, he needs this. And no, once again, he just cannot get those landings.
One wonders what must be going through Gable's mind. Three Olympic spots up for grabs. He's up against the reigning national champion in the United States, Johnny Weir, former national champ, Michael Weiss, and Evan Lysacek, the reigning world bronze medalist, and a long program that just isn't firing.
You have to wonder if he will even make it to the Olympic Games this year. He's the bronze medalist in Salt Lake City, but just hasn't been able to get that form back. Manages a triple-triple combination at the end of the program, but I think it's a little, too late.
I think you can see it on his face, and I think you can see it in the reactions.
Well, everything just looks like a struggle for him. The spins, the footwork, the jumps. Nothing is coming easy to him.
So look at the quad attempt. He fails after 2.5 revolutions. And for a man who used to do quads like most of us roll out of bed, it's almost sad to see him have this much difficulty with those jumps. Here's the very last combination of the program, the triple flip, triple toe, and even that he had some difficulty with.
And you're right. It's almost painful to watch. A man who landed 3 quads for the bronze in Salt Lake City at the Olympics, humbled by these scores, relatively low scores in the free skate. It does move him into second overall, but there's still some powerful skaters to come as we continue at the Grand Prix of France.
Most aware of this is American Timothy Gabel.
To make it out of U.S. Nationals, to get a spot in the Olympic team is really my main focus this year. So, you know, if I skate well at Nationals, if I skate better than this at Nationals and do get a spot on the team, then it's something that I'll be thinking about. But right now I'm just trying to prepare for the U.S. Championships and make sure that when I show up at Nationals, I don't do any single jumps in my long.
And right now, American Tim Gabel is holding on to second spot in for Romania, that country's 7-time champion, Jorge Kieper, 27-year-old veteran, was 5th in this Grand Prix last season, comes in 3rd after the short with a personal best score, so looks promising to move up from last year's spot.
And on paper, this program is technically as solid as any we're going to see in this competition.
Setting up for his triple axel combination. Very nice. Triple axel, double toe.
It's been a while since we saw a man land a big time jump.
Setting up for his second triple axel.
Spoke too soon, Terry. Triple toe combination, a very high scoring element here. Triple, triple, a bit of a 2-foot landing there.
You gotta believe he saw those boards coming and wanted to make sure he landed on the ice and not over the boards.
The Kieper clan is quite a family unit. He is coached and choreographed by his wife, Sandra Schaar. His daughter, 5-year-old Flora, can often be seen in his arms as he skates around after practice.
Another triple-double combination, triple flip, double toe. hoop jump. And a hard fall on his triple Lutz attempt. You saw when he made contact with the ice, left foot still crossed over in front of right, nowhere near the position he wants to be to land the jump. And that was a single axle. That one buffaloes me because he's already done two triple axles in this program, and you're not allowed to repeat any one triple more than twice. So whether he's changed this program slightly on the fly, I don't know. But that seemed to be, to me, a bit of a waste of a jump window, and the men only have eight to use.
Keeper of Romania delivered on a number of fronts in terms of the triple jumps. Question mark will be, is it enough to catch? Well, I think Jeffrey Buttle's out of range, but perhaps Timothy Gabel is within the realm of possibility.
He looks pleased with this performance. Here's a look at the triple axel that he opened with into a double toe loop.
And he would follow that up with a very good triple-triple combination. Here's the triple Lutz. He knows the boards are coming, but he shows some good patience, stays nice and tight, and gets the triple toe done. Not the greatest of landings, but he gets the job done. Here was the triple Lutz that he fell on. You can see the lean. This was late in the program, a little fatigue setting in here, and he misses that jump.
So, for Romanian, your gatekeeper, it becomes abundantly clear. Score 116.16 and catch Gable and claim the second position. Technical elements down a bit. Program components, which are the artistic components, way up there. And yes, he will do it. He needed 116 and change. He got 125.70. That's the second best free skate of the day thus far and places your gatekeeper of Romania in second spot, with Brian Joubert still to come, the last skater. And the reason you get the double fist is he's going to be on the podium. There is France's Brian Joubert, the 2004 World Championship silver medalist. He's been here in Paris as France's own Brian Joubert is the final skater in the final group. Sights set on the leader, and that leader is Canada's Jeffrey Buttle. Oh, one can only imagine what's going through Madame Joubert's mind.
She's at least sitting in the stands. Our own Canadian Olympic silver medalist Brian Orser, his mother used to have to go out and pace the hallways and only peek in from time to time to see how he was skating.
So did my mom.
Open the program, scheduled quad toe. Little turn on the landing, but otherwise very well done.
First quad we've seen landed.
And the triple axel. Brian needs all the jumps because his spins and his steps and his overall program is not of the same quality as Jeff Buttle. And there's a triple-triple combination.
second after the short program, coming off of bronze at Skate America.
Second triple axel attempt, and he doubles it.
Some have suggested that this man, Brian Joubert, and world champion Stéphane Lambiel represent the rare European men who can make inroads to world and Olympic titles.
A little tight, maybe a little tired, some difficulty with that triple loop. You really need to have some superior knee action on an edge jump, and he did not have it there. Triple sow cow, but you can even hear on the landing the noise that the edge made tells you he's not quite fully on top of the skate where he wants to be.
He skates to Lord of the Dance. Could he be Lord of the Rink?
I really want to like this program, but when you choose a piece of music like Lord of the Dance, it speaks volumes about rhythm, about dancing, about staying with the music. There are only sporadic moments along the way that he actually pays attention to that. For the entire first minute to minute and a half of this program, who knows what could be playing, because he's certainly not using the music to its potential. Yes, you have to concentrate on elements like that, the quad, and get them done, but it's the true champion that combines the ability to interpret and work with the music and incorporate the big ticket items that's going to be at the top of the podium in Turin.
And how do you compare this with Buttle? Buttle missed four jumps, and Joubert missed two jumps, but Buttle has far superior spins, far superior steps, far superior choreography. I'm going to guess that Buttle is going to stay ahead of this.
This was one of the few moments during the course of the program that he worked with the music, and so one should through the footwork section. But this program, there's a level that it has the potential to reach, but it just isn't there yet.
Yes, but look at that technical element score. Better than Buttle, who is in the lead, but that is not good enough. That free skate, he needed way more than that to catch Jeffrey Buttle, who has claimed the gold here in the Grand Prix of France. Brian Joubert, much to the consternation of the home crowd, is the silver medalist. Look at the final standings now. Jeffrey Buttle improves to gold from his Skate Canada silver. Joubert, the silver lining here, considering the national championships are just around the corner. And how about this? Your gatekeeper wins his first Grand Prix medal, and it's the first Grand Prix medal ever for Romania. Canadian Jeff Buttle atop the medal podium here in Paris, following up the Skate Canada silver with gold today. And this has been a remarkable start to international figure skating for Canada. Consider this, Emmanuel Sandu of Canada won Grand Prix events at Skate Canada, backed it up with Cup of China, and now Buttle is victorious here in France.
I think the real boost was in the skate, really. It wasn't the best, but it was better than Skate Canada, so I'm going to take from that, you know, anything that I need to fix up and be better for the final.